when we are talking about this core self, it is an emotional part of us and it requires a mate to heal itself for further evolution. I'll give you a traditional definition of soulmate, twin self. So the story goes like that we are all whole, but before we are born, we are cut into halves. Now these two halves are put into various incarnations, and every incarnation there is a deep unfulfilled need because they are not meeting each other. So the meeting point will happen when they have evolved, because there is a contract between these two selves, and once they meet, they live a very deep love life and they release. They go out of this physical world. Now, this story is a lot on the physical side. I won't resonate with this story a lot. Our being takes various ways to develop ourselves. It is something like, you can say there are rivers, there are streams, there are creeks coming down from the hills, from different places, and it meets the sea. Sea, I'm meaning here as the consciousness, the oneness. Now, these different ways of the water flowing can denote different lives, parallel lives. It can be that one of your part is in the animal kingdom, learning its lesson. One of his parts has incarnated like an angel in some other dimension. So we are multidimensional beings. It's not only limited to gender. If I have to come to the gender part, there are souls that have contracts that until they evolve fully or they accept themselves fully, they have an agenda. They are not going to meet the other part of themselves. You know, it's kind of like fragments of our core being residing here and there. It's not with us. And there is a deep craving for these cells to come back to us. Hence, we keep on meeting soulmates. So there is a difference between soulmates and twin flame. What is soulmates? Soulmates are these different parts that will come back to us from time to time. I'll give you an example. I was working with a man. He's a researcher. He goes around the world. He told me that I am a researcher. I'm a very well-known person, but I did not know how to communicate. I had no communication skills. But then I met a German woman and I was in relationship with that woman for 5 years. And that was the time I learned communication, because generally women, they are good at communication and she was very good at that. So their meeting together, this scientist could really start speaking about his expression, his idea and creativity, and that's how he could flourish. And of course, I'm sure the woman also got a part back in her, which she was missing. So this is what I call, when you meet your soulmate, you get a fragment of your soul, because it's like a mirror. That person brings that part back to you. Another example I'll give, I was working with one man and he said, you know, when I met this woman, oh my God, it was like an intense relationship. It was love and hate both. So this woman was bringing the fears. She was triggering the fears of this man. When he was able to embrace his fears, he could look into his fears. Something magical started happening. This man's psyche was very closed. He never used to get proper dreams. He didn't remember dreams. He couldn't visualize better. His extrasensory perception started opening up. He became a dreamer. He could use his intuition for his spiritual work. So this woman, this dark side of the personality brought, you know, ignited the deeper parts of this man in him, the intuitive part. This is what the soulmate is doing. It's like a projection. Basically, it is you yourself, a part of yourself that is being brought to you. You remember this part by this person, the soulmates. So soulmates with the S, but then there's something called a twin flame. When you are in alignment with your real center, you attract this twin flame. So it says the soulmates get you prepared to meet the twin flame. A twin flame is that part of yourself that's going to take you into this highest potential of yourself that you need. I'm going to come in a moment of how you can attract a twin flame. But what generally happens is a person goes through intense loneliness, a deep craving of, oh, something is missing in me. And this craving is nothing but a step forward to returning home for being complete. It's like you are going back home. So this person comes to your life when you are aligned to your center and helps you to accelerate your journey in returning back home. But what happens if you're not aligned? It can be a lot turbulent. It's like you're holding a high charge and you really don't know what to do about it. So these relationships can be very intense if we are not aligned, if we are not prepared. So when you meet this person, you have a sense of knowing them as if two of you are sharing the same kind of journey. It's not that if you are an artist, you will meet a person who is also an artist. It's not like that. But you are the core, like possibly here, the core is creativity. You will both be supporting each other's journey. It's complementary. And two of you would have like a greater attraction to each other, just not physical attraction. Feel an attraction on all the levels, physically, mentally, emotionally, energetically. And both of you would be attracted to each other's strengths. So that you will be complementing each other's strengths. Sometimes it can be the opposite also. You would be triggering each other's, you know, pushing the buttons of each other so that you remind yourself about this strength. But though you are pushing each other's button, still you will find a very strong pull towards each other. It is as if you are looking into the baggage of each other. And you are not judging each other's baggage. You are just in an unconditional acceptance of their baggage, which you both would be working on and finally resolve. Before you are meeting this person, you might have a clear dream about this person. Now, I have a friend and he told me that I used to draw a picture of a girl from my childhood, a certain picture. Whenever he used to sit idle, he'll be drawing that picture. And this girl, the same exact picture had shown up in his life and he instantly knew it is her. Now this being that I'm saying, the center of the being, it is getting created because you have a lot of past life experiences. You have contracts, soul contracts, and you have signed these contracts that we are going to meet in so and so time, not before that. So sometimes a soul review can tell you, why do I feel this utter loneliness? Why do I have this urge to meet my soulmate, my twin flame? Why am I not able to manifest? What is my contract? When you're with this person, you feel a sense of completeness, a wholeness inside you, as if, you know, you are at home. And the moment you are apart, you feel there is something missing, as if there is a pull all the time that wants you to be together. They can mirror your issues. Equally, they can also mirror your strengths. Once you are balanced in this relationship with your twin flame, or maybe your soulmate, you find that you are in your full potential. Like you feel so confident inside. You feel powerful. Like you are capable of doing anything. And you feel like an upward spiral journey has started for you spiritually. You can't ignore that. Sometimes you feel each other's inless. Even being far, you know, what is the emotional state of my twin flame from very far? So friends, it's like a lost part of you, long forgotten, and it's coming back to you. It's like a satisfaction of a very deep yearning. So the growth is much faster, much stronger, profound when you are with your twin flame. It accelerates 10 times, 100 times. You can feel this growth. You can't be unaware in this relationship. You are very, very aware. You are living an aware life. So all the earlier soulmates had been preparing you for this twin mate, as if you are waiting for him or her your entire life and you have met them. Finally, you are spending time with your twin flame, more is your evolution, more is your growth, more you are getting better. And it can be seen by your close friends, your relatives. Of course, you are noticing it first. But these two, not only they are impacting their own growth, they are impacting everyone around them. We need more of these couples on the earth plane. It's a blessing if twin flame are existing. They're healing everyone around them. Question is now, how do you get your twin flame? First thing is radical self-acceptance. What do I mean? Improve your relationship with yourself first. it has to be like a dramatic improvement. The way you treat yourself, you would be working on your self-worth, self-empowerment. Because once you meet your twin flame, you are both holding a positive mirror for each other. So if you don't have that kind of mirror for yourself before you meet the twin flame, you will be triggered by that relationship because you will not be able to take that. Your wires are not wired properly. So there will be short circuits. Second thing, accept your flaws. I'll tell you something very interesting, which I learned. Spiritual people who are always working on themselves, they will never get a twin flame. I'm saying something very strong. Why? Because they feel they have to keep improving themselves. There is a problem with themselves. If that idea is there that I have to improve on myself to meet someone, that's not how you meet your twin soul. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to be better to meet your twin soul. It's okay to have the dark shades, the darker side of yourself. Embrace that. And the third thing, how do you meet your twin flame? If you have a deep desire, then know that you are going to meet your twin flame. Because if you have this desire needs to be fulfilled. It has been given to you to be fulfilled. So I think this is the good news for all of us, that if we believe in twin souls, if we think we are destined to meet them, we will meet our twin souls.